evening, everybody, and welcome to a special edition of 41's Friday Night Basketball. Tonight from the Dome at Lumen Christi, a berth in the Final Four is at stake as Battle Creek Central meets Ann Arbor Huron. I'm Mark Crawford. Next to me, the old coach, Bill Brandel.
Mark, by the time you get this far in the tournament...
1,000 on hand at the Breslin for this one. The 23-4 River Rats going for their first state title in school history.
This is the Huron High School basketball team. If one was to pay attention to the Michigan High School basketball scene, they've most likely heard quite a bit about this program. Over the past 15 years, Ann Arbor Huron has been recognized as one of the top basketball programs in the entire state. Coach Waleed Samaha is one of the most important factors of why this high school in Southeast Michigan is commonly recognized as a powerhouse, as the coaching Samaha has provided for this school is second to none. Although the River Rats from Ann Arbor have recorded 15-plus win seasons year after year, the program is yet to win a state championship. The most recent season where the River Rats have came close to winning the state championship was back in 2010 when they faced off against the Kalamazoo Central Maroons in the state semifinals. Ever since then, the program hasn't made it back to that point. However, the team Coach Samaha had in session for the 2019 and 2020 season was like no other. For some backstory, the River Rats had a rough 2018 through 2019 season. This is likely due to the lack of varsity basketball experience and how young the team was. This roster was comprised of 7 sophomores, 6 juniors, and only 2 seniors. Out of this youthful group of hoopers, only 4 of these players were returning, and only one of these returning players got a handful of varsity starting experience, that being the sophomore guard, Devin Womack. This team was definitely not one of the most successful Huron teams as of the past decade, as the program went 13-8 that year, and were dropped off by the Saline Hornets in the first round of the playoffs. Although the Huron community was aware that this young team wasn't going to have a great year, the people knew that the program was going to have huge success in the future seasons.
I thought the 2019 Huron varsity basketball team was, they were good, but they were very young, very inexperienced at the varsity level. You could see a lot of potential in these young kids. Very smart basketball group, very high IQ. Worked really hard, and you know, I just felt that this young group, they were going to be something special, you know, by the time that they were seniors. So you know, future's bright for them, and I can't wait to see what they have in store.
Following the 2019 Michigan high school basketball season, the River Rats were destined to make big changes and dominate the following season. The program was scheduled to play summer league games all across the state at different colleges. In these summer league games, Huron was constantly matched up against elite competition, such as the Grand Blanc High Bobcats, who would end up at the top of the state rankings at the end of the 2020 high school basketball season. The season was rapidly approaching, and the student body, the team, and the rest of their community was beyond ready to rally around the River Rats, following a slightly underwhelming 2019 season. The team is now made up of 9 juniors and 4 seniors. Out of these 13 players on the roster, 10 of them, yes, 10 of them, are returning with varsity basketball experience. What are the expectations that are set for the varsity team on and off the court?
On the court, we expect to win all the championships like conference, district, our league play, and all the way up to state and regionals. And off the court, we're supposed to maintain a 3.0 GPA at least, and we want to be an academic all-state along with like not doing any drugs, of course, and all the other stuff.
The young core of Huron basketball has turned into an experienced group of basketball players. What did the team get out of last year that will make this season so much better?
I think we got out of last year like the pain of feeling a hard loss, especially to a team that we have beaten multiple times earlier in the season, and we didn't like really know what to do when they started like scouting us and taking away all of our plays. But I think now we have like a better understanding of what we could do to like play without the structure of having to run a simple play, which the defense can take away.
Here on basketball, I'm pretty sure we're definitely winning districts because this year, like you already know, Pioneer, they don't have Drew Lauder or Kaysen or whatever his last name is. And Skyline is terrible this year. Lincoln, they're just overrated. And Monty Bates, he's good, but that's one person. So I think we're gonna win districts. Win regionals. Hey, I'm saying state championships, but I'm optimistic. You already know. I think Huron basketball could go undefeated. And you already know with the boys in the student section, we got their backs. We're gonna make sure the gym's hype. Like basketball and like all sports just like kind of make us all a family. Like we're like, it makes me like personally proud to be a River Rat. And like how like everyone on the team, like those are my brothers. I've known them for a minute. So like I really like have that support for them and I really want them to push through. And in the student section, we're basically their support system. When they're losing, we make sure we're hype so they know like there's somebody rooting for them, you know.
As you can see, the people associated with Huron basketball have very high expectations as athletes and as young men. Following the 2019 season, standouts Devin Womack, Julian Lewis, and Mike Robinson have stepped up as leaders by exemplifying the desire to be successful and to be a champion. These three players all had statement seasons in 2019 and built off of what they had started and continued to further develop their skills throughout the summer and fall seasons. The talent that was put on display by these three resulted in several college coaches stopping by to watch some of the off-season practices happening at Huron High School. As a student, I remember walking through the gym a couple times after school and seeing 3 to 5 college coaches at the Huron basketball workouts, observing the kind of players and people that were part of the program. Prior to the start of the 2019 through 2020 Michigan High School basketball season, Julian managed to pick up 7 offers to play basketball at the Division I level. These offers were coming from Youngstown State, Oakland, Western Michigan, Eastern Michigan, Toledo, Duquesne, and Denver. Mike Robinson also managed to pick up an offer from an NAIA school while also getting attention from several colleges, along with Womack.
How have you developed as a basketball player throughout the years as a Huron basketball player?
It's been a really fun process. Freshman year, I didn't make varsity team, and that really inspired me to get better. So I just kept working and working. When the sophomore year rolled around, I was on the varsity team and I was a starter. And that year I did really, really well. I averaged 12 points, had like 9.8 rebounds. And that always from that day, I've just been trying to get better because I always want to play and just be the best I can be.
How has Huron basketball helped you get opportunities to go on and play at the next level?
Just through my coaches and me playing hard has given me many opportunities to play at the next level. Like I have to shout out my coach Maha. He's been there throughout like my whole career in high school and before that, and he's really reached out to coaches for me, and it's just like really fun knowing you have like somebody that cares and that can get you to where you need to go in life. And that's pretty much the whole process.
What is the team's number one priority this season?
I think the team's number one priority this season is win a state championship, but more than that, just be a great team on and off the court, bond together, find what makes us unique, what makes us a good team, and what makes us really strong.
You're a genius, McFly!
The schedule the Rats had ahead of them was quite a daunting one. Out of the team's scheduled 21 regular season games, 12 of these matchups were against opponents ranked within the top 75 teams in the entire state. Not only did the River Rats have tough opponents ahead of them, game after game, but they also had to play under the brightest lights and around the biggest crowds. To start off the season, Huron matched up against Detroit Edison Public School Academy at the EMU Convocation Center. The Convocation Center is also home to the Eastern Michigan basketball teams. DEPSA is ranked within the top 25 as well. To say the least, playing this team isn't the easiest way to start the season, as the school is well known for developing very high-level college athletes. Huron managed to fend off DEPSA in a close matchup, only beating them by 3 points. But this was only the beginning of the gauntlet Samaha and his crew had ahead of them. Their next game was also another matchup against a top-ranked team, with what ESPN considers the best player in the entire state. That player is Isaiah Jackson. Isaiah Jackson is a 4-star recruit, ranked 30th nationally out of all high school basketball players within the senior class, and he will be attending the blue chip program Kentucky Wildcats for his college basketball career. This matchup is one of the most anticipated and toughest matchups the team would come across the entire season. However, come game time, there was some last minute news surrounding the top-ranked Hooper Jackson, as he wouldn't partake in the game due to being injured. But the River Rats didn't pay attention to the fact that Isaiah was hurt and stayed the course.
LP back with you, and we go back to the Horatio Williams Classic at North Farmington, where number 16 Waterford Mott would not have the services of the injured superstar Isaiah Jackson. Packed house, and right off the bat, the fast break was working. Phillip Leonard pulled down the rebound. DeQuavion Washington quickly outlet it to a streaking Azion Price, who finishes nicely at the rim. Toussaint Fancher is boxed in. Think again. Ball back up top. The junior Devin Womack with a dribble drive. The left-handed finish. He led all scorers with 16 points. Huron led 17-4 at the end of the first. But the Rats kept very active in the offensive end. This is the junior Mike Davis getting creative. It was 30-13 in favor of Ann Arbor Huron at the break. Mott down 27, and they wouldn't get any closer. Huron too much. Womack spots Mike Robinson Jr. in transition. He'll throw down the two-handed jackhammer. Mr. Robinson had 15 points in the contest. Another throwdown, and Huron led this one tape to tape. River Rats beat Waterford Mott 67-38, the final.
Yeah, this is the team the community wanted to see. Not only was this team gritty and persevering, but anyone on this roster could check into that game and make an immediate impact.
This year, I've never seen anything like it. This is the best basketball team I've ever seen play. Up and down, that lineup was made for each other. They really made me proud to be a Huron River Rat because, you know, Huron sports aren't always the best. For example, the football team isn't always the most successful.
And from this point, the Rats kept winning and winning and winning, and you get the point. They were unstoppable as they were running their opponents off the court, beating several of the other teams by more than 20. Fast forward to late January, and the Huron River Rats are 9-0, and high school sports media networks are talking all about them. The D-Zone, one of the most popular networks of them all, ranked Huron as the second best team in the entire state, ranked over the reigning state champs Ipsy Lincoln, and just behind a loaded Orchard Lake St. Mary's roster. In an MLive article, Lewis said, "We've really been playing together and just trusting each other. We're being intentional in everything we do, and playing together and playing hard has really been successful." The next team the Rats would run into is one of their crosstown rivals, Ann Arbor Skyline. Skyline is a similar team to Huron, as their roster is also made up of mainly juniors. This game also took place on a Friday night at the Huron Dome, so the student section was going to be jumping for the first time all season for the River Rats. Have it. Huron dubbed Skyline in their first meeting by 5 points. The game was much closer than anticipated, but the Rats would then go on to slaughter their other rivals in the following week, beating Saline by 17 and the Pioneers from Ann Arbor Pioneer by 21. The Rats were on top, and it didn't look like the train could be stopped. Well, that was until...